Can you assess your team's defensive execution, including the keeping your hands up and away from the three-point shooters?
Well, we did a pretty good job, but James still got us two or three times, three or four times, I don't remember. And you know, we reached. You just can't do it. It's hard to be disciplined on him, but it's really important. And we lost that discipline a few times.
Greg, Brian Smith, Houston Chronicle. How have you, after the game went blowout, how have you seen your team respond these last two games, especially tonight on the road without Tony, in terms of how they stuck together and the whole team played?
Well, you know, obviously they responded well.
Michael Wright, ESPN. Coach, how have you seen LaMarcus sort of handle the struggles and the success throughout this series so far?
Well, this was his best game, you know, obviously, but he felt good tonight. He was loose as far as his physical nature, his legs and everything. He wasn't too stiff, and it showed. You know, he moved up and down the court well. He was able to push off on the block. He felt good shooting the ball. So, in addition to, you know, busting his butt on D and trying to hit the boards for us, he was a big help tonight.
Bob Orsborn, San Antonio Express News. Can you talk a little more about what went into the decision to start for Jonathan, and how do you think he did it?
We started it because that's what we thought would be best for us. And I think he was fine. It was a good initiation in a big game like this to get out there and get some time. And he did the best he could.
Tim McMahon, ESPN. You talked about after game one about the importance of keeping them out of transition. What would be the most important factors in you guys being able to do that successfully?
You know, transition D isn't really about, it sounds kind of counterintuitive. It's not really about defense, it's more about offense. Bad offense leads to transition. Fortunately, I don't think either team executed very well offensively in the first half, although they made threes. But the better, you know, if you're making shots, or you're shooting free throws, there's not a whole lot of transition you have to worry about. So, you know, good execution at that end will help that. That's what we did so poorly in the first game for sure.
Greg, the last two games you had, Pau Gasol, you obviously put him starting lineup after game two. What's he been able to bring to you guys in size? And sometimes it's not just the scoring, but it's the rebounding, it's his intensity in the paint, but that kind of veteran experience.
Well, every series is different. It could be someone in a starting lineup, or it could be someone off the bench that you think matches up better in certain ways. So in this series, we just decided at the beginning that Pau and LA together would be our best lineup. So we've gone with it.